Alan McMorrin.
Yes, thank you, Chair. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak. I just wanted to say the UK government must absolutely have meaningful engagement with devolved administrations over the shape of UK future customs and tariff regime post-Brexit. This has not been the case for the UK government so far. And just like the EU withdrawal bill, the trade bill does put restrictions on the executive capacity of the Scottish and Welsh governments, while placing no restrictions on the capacity of the UK government. Essentially, under this bill, UK ministers will be able to legislate in devolved areas without consent from Welsh or Scottish ministers. This is an overt power grab and a rolling back of devolution. And I am personally proud to have played a part in devolution, in bringing that about 20 years ago in Wales. And it's vital that we maintain what devolution was set up to deliver, a proud and confident nation. And it's also disappointing there's no provision for the Trade Remedies Authority to have any input from devolved nations. Of course, it's important to be an independent and impartial body separate from government, and it must represent all parts of the UK, including Wales and Scotland. And it's important also to remember that in the initial white paper, the trade white paper, the UK government stated that this act would have provisions that the UK ministers would seek consent from Welsh and Scottish ministers when legislating in secondary legislation under this act. This has now disappeared in the bill. First Minister Karen Jones told the Welsh Assembly's External Affairs and the Legislation Committee in 2016, last year, that it was hugely important for devolved administrations and legislators to have a say in the negotiation of future agreements that will impact on Wales. One specific example could be a free trade agreement with New Zealand, for example. The impact of that might be to remove the current controls that exist on the import of New Zealand lamb, for example. If they were to go, that would clearly cause great difficulty for Welsh lamb producers. And that issue may not be as apparent in Whitehall as it is in Wales, but that is simply an example of why it's so important the views of devolved governments are understood and the interests of devolved nations are respected. So it's not something new. We're not advocating new devolved powers. It's not even about extending devolution, it's about preserving devolution. And it's important to also remember that there are restrictions on competence. The devolved settlements of both Wales and Scotland ensure that both Welsh and Scottish ministers cannot legislate in ways that interfere with UK international obligations. And that comes under the Government of Wales Act, specifically Section 82 and 114. It simply cannot legislate to interfere.
Anna Barber, making an excellent speech and really highlighting the importance and the journey we've travelled in terms of devolution, but particularly on the devolved settlement. Does she agree with me that, you know, there might be challenges, if this amendment passes and it's about consent, but as she says, it's written into the devolution settlements, and that agreement would have to be reached to make sure that legislation is passed. But it would be absolutely in the interest of devolution and in the interest of Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland that those amendments pass today.
Thank you. Thank you to the Honourable Member. It is absolutely about consent and agreement and consultation. But essentially, it's about not rolling back on the devolution settlement. So amending the bill to explicitly ask for the consent of devolved administrations for secondary legislation under this trade bill would therefore not interfere with that, nor would it amount to a veto power. And as I already mentioned, what was drafted in the UK government's paper, this should already be in the bill, as was set out in the white paper. Indeed, this is at the very heart of what devolution is all about. Consent in devolved and consultation in devolved areas. So if there is secondary legislation being made within an area that is currently within devolved competence, the devolved administrations and Welsh ministers must have consent. And in short, the democratically elected Welsh Assembly or Scottish Parliament is able to debate it. That is why I agree in with the principle underlying these amendments, as agreed by both the Welsh and Scottish governments. Professor Jones, a Welsh political expert, told the Brexit Committee that the UK government is in effect reintroducing conferred powers model, where it will decide which bits of power returning from Brussels will be conferred on the Welsh government, that in the context of this constant churn and change seemed objectional and one-sided to him, and also to Welsh ministers, MPs and Assembly members. The most disappointing aspect of this trade bill's disregard for devolution is the UK government knows it's completely unacceptable.
I'm grateful to the Honourable Lady, and it's excellent to have a member from Wales speaking, because I think obviously naturally we've heard from the Scottish member who's representing this. Do I take it from what she's saying that obviously she supports the principle and therefore she'll be supporting the Honourable Lady's amendment?
I thank the Honourable Member for his intervention. As I said, I can confirm I absolutely support this principle, which has been agreed jointly with the Welsh Government and the Scottish Government. Ministers and Conservative MPs, as well as civil servants, privately acknowledge how extremely ill-advised it is to remove the power of devolved governments over devolved areas. Clearly the issue is one of trust. Trust to exercise devolved powers responsibly. Trust to carry out measures that represent the people of Wales and Scotland. And trust to provide meaningful scrutiny of legislation. As it stands, under this bill and after Brexit, the devolved governments will be at the mercy of Whitehall, with complete control of all areas, including those which are currently devolved. This is called rolling back of devolution. And this is why we must have, as set out in your white paper, the right for devolved governments to give consent over secondary legislation in areas of devolved competence.
Yeah.